Good morning, students. Welcome. Today's topic, Nationalism in India. Very important topic of our class 10th CBSE lesson. Very important and very easy topic also, because we are discussing about freedom struggle of India from our lower classes. As you have seen, previous chapter, Nationalism in Europe. That idea of nationalism has developed, or it has been associated with the formation of nation state, where people have developed a understanding of who they were, what defined their identity, and a sense of belonging. Like if you look at, if you just try to compare or recollect the German people, there is no country called Germany, but there were German speaking people under different monarchs. So these people developed a feeling. They started understanding who they are. They wanted some identity for themselves. They wanted a sense of belonging towards a nation. So finally, their struggle led to the formation of a nation state. Nationalism, in the sense, loyalty towards the nation, devotion towards the nation. So along with that, new symbols, new icons, and new songs. These ideas have given links and they have redefined the boundaries of the communities. In most countries, the making of this national identity was a long process. If you have seen whether the formation of a nation state of Italy or Britain or Germany, you have seen it's a long process. Then these nation states are being created due to a lot of struggle among the peoples. They have to fight, they have to struggle. They have to struggle for their identity, for a sense of collective belonging. Then finally they have developed the idea. Then what about India? How this consensus developed in India? How this consensus or the feeling of nationalism emerged in India is our topic. India, as you know, it was a colony. What is meant by colony? Colony in the sense, under the control of another country. India was a colony of Britain for nearly 200 years. Then how that feeling of nationalism emerged in India? This feeling has closely related, it's closely connected with anti-colonial movement. When people started going through the oppressions of the Britishers, then they started discovering their unity in the process of their struggle with colonialism. And this the sense of being oppressed shared a bond that tied many different groups together. Different sections of the society were there, and all these sections of the society were oppressed by the Britishers. Try to recollect with your previous year's lessons. Freedom struggle you have studied in class 7th, class 8th, class 6th and 7th. You have studied ancient history, medieval history of India. Then medieval history of India has been different. India was under the control of different monarchs. Then finally the Britishers have come. They started ruling. They have oppressed each and every section of the society is being oppressed by the Britishers. Each group had a different impact. Each group felt the effects of colonialism differently. Their experiences were varied, and their notions of freedom also were not always the same. In the sense, suppose if you take a peasant, for farmer, farmers were forced to grow only commercial crops, indigo, cotton. They were not, and they used to purchase those crops at the less cost. They were not allowed to grow food crops. So farmers wanted freedom from the Britishers in the way of growing this indigo. Suppose if you take indigo, if once a farmer grows indigo, the land becomes infertile. So he wanted freedom from that. If you look at Zamindar has to pay a lot of revenue to the Britisher. So he wanted to get freedom from the Britishers in the way of reduction of revenue. If you look at a trader had a lot of control through by the British manufacturers. He has to pay lot many taxes, a lot of control, no freedom of market for the Indian traders. So they wanted freedom of market. Even Indian soldiers also, if you remember Sepoy Mutiny, they were not given proper priority. If you remember class 9th, Forest Society and Colonialism, even forest and wildlife also been tribal peoples, the effect of Britishers on the tribal people. So each section of the society oppressed by the Britishers, they were under the control, they were being exploited by the Britishers. So for them, their experiences are different. for tribal people, control on the forest area, for peasants, freedom to grow the crop they feel like, for traders, freedom of movement of markets, for zamindars, administrative powers in their hands and financial control in their hands. So each section of the society has a different notion of freedom because their experiences are different. Whereas these, all these different ideas, different notions has been come under one umbrella, and the person who is able to bring all these notions together and merge them into one feeling of nationalism was the great leader Mahatma Gandhi. So the Congress under Mahatma Gandhi tried to forge these groups together within one movement. But this unity did not emerge without a conflict. There were few conflicts because people were different, their experiences were different, their notions of freedom were different. Though there was unity, with some conflict it was there. Have a look at the timeline of British India. In the year 1600, Britishers entered into India as traders through a company known as East India Company. Few British traders entered into India to do trade. By 1615, what happened? They occupied, they made their first territory in India. By 1792, they were able to consolidate major part of India. Then after these many struggles, finally 1857, we call it as Revolt of 1857, we call it as Sipahi Mutiny, we call it as First War of Independence also. Can you recollect? Jhansi Lakshmi Bai, Tantia Tope, Nana Saheb, Begum Hazrat Mahal, under the leadership of Bahadur Shah Zafar, last Mughal Emperor, they all have revolted against the British. But it was of not much success. Finally, 1858, Britishers were able to crush this Sipahi mutiny. 1857, First War of Independence, by 1858, the Britishers were able to crush the Sipahi mutiny. Then, now till 1857, the overall India was under the control of few traders who have come to India to do the trade, that is East India Company. After 1858 on, British Crown has taken over the charge. 1877, Queen Victoria becomes the Empress of India. Whether it is East India Company or whether it is the Britain Queen, the exploitation is the same. They exploited Indian resources. So if we move forward, after this revolt of 1857, one major change from the British side, now India is directly under the control of Britain Queen. One more major change is in the year 1855, when Indian National Congress was formed. So from 1855 to 1905, we call it as Moderates era. These moderates like W.C. Banerjee, Gopalakrishna Gokhale, these people believed in request, petition, prayer, meetings with the Britishers so that their demands can be accepted by the Britishers. Whereas 1905 is known as the era of extremist in the Indian National Congress itself. The people like Lal Bal Pal, can you recollect these names? Can you say the full form of Lal Bal Pal full name? And these people are called as Garam Masala also. Lal, Lala Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak and Pal Bipin Chandra Pal. These three are the people who started demanding. They said that it's not the request and petitions which are going to work. We have every right to demand from the British. Then that this era is known as extremist phase. Once after the entry of Gandhi in the year 1919, then the overall look of Indian National Congress and the Indian freedom struggle has changed. And we call from 1919 to 1948, we call it as Gandhian era. So in class 8, you have discussed about the nationalism in India during the first decade of 20th century. In this topic, we are going to start our story from 1920, like Gandhian era, and how Gandhiji has led the movements like non-cooperation movement and civil disobedience movement, and how Congress has sought to develop this national movement, how different social groups participated in the movement, how nationalism captured the imagination of the people. All these points we'll discuss in detail in today's topic of nationalism.
Holds a significant place in Indian history. it witnessed the first revolt against the mighty British Empire in India. What started as the sepoy mutiny soon spread out like wildfire, mainly across northern and central India. However, this sporadic revolt failed due to the lack of coordination and planning of the revolutionaries. Nevertheless, technically, the revolt of 1857 remains the first war of Indian independence. This realization of national identity was a lengthy process. It also involved common people, leaders, and revolutionaries to bring about change. Let's study how the consciousness of one nation emerged in India. In India, the rise of nationalism was intricately linked with the opposition of colonialism, similar to the way it happened in Vietnam. People realized that they were experiencing a common suffering under the oppressive British colonial rule. This understanding brought the different groups together in their anti-colonial struggle. However, each group developed its own method of struggle against the British rule. The event which proved instrumental in the history of the Indian freedom struggle was the First World War. India had been forced to take part in the First World War, in which Britain had fought against Germany.
As you all know, the year 1914 to 1918 are referred to as the year of First World War. In the previous chapter also we have seen Balkan areas, conflict in Balkan areas, with the influence of European powers, it has led to First World War. Though the World War started in Europe, it has affected not just Europe, the entire world has been affected due to it. Reason? Colonies. These European countries had their colonies all over the world. So they have involved colonies also into the war. That's what we refer to it as First World War. So Allied powers. And during this World War time, there were two powers fighting against each other. One is Allied power, another one is Central power. Allied power consists of Britain, Russia and France. Allied power consists of Britain, Russia and France. Whereas Central power consists of Germany, Austro-Hungary and India. So in what way this First World War is related to India? Because of Britain. Because of Britain, as Britain was also in the war and India was a colony of Britain, though India not directly but indirectly India is involved in the war because of Britain. Unintentionally, though people of India doesn't like to be part of a war, they were being forcefully involved and Indians had to face the effects of the First World War. So in this topic of the First World War, let us see in what way the year 1919, after the end of First World War, how the national movement has emerged, how different social groups have come together, and how these developments happened, what are the implications we are going to study now. So it is about First World War, and the war created a new economic and political situation, one of the important questions of this topic also. Directly we may get a question, war created a new economic and political situation, analyze the statement. Or you may get the question as, in what way First World War has its impact on India. So our answer starts this way. So what do we need for war? For war we need money, yes, another is soldiers. Money, what happened in the way of taxes. So the Britishers, as India was a colony, so Britishers extracted money and the people also from India, though Indians doesn't like, forcefully they have extracted from India. So in what way? So this huge, there is huge increase in defense expenditure because of war. So what happened, this war loans, how they have been able to get it? By increasing taxes. And what type of taxes? Like customs duties raised. And income tax introduced. For the first time, income tax was been introduced. In the sense, paying amount on the income which we are earning, even till today we are paying income tax. So, what is the first thing? In order to increase, in order to get the defense expenditure, they have increased taxes. And in that taxes, customs duties were raised and income tax increased. So, once the taxes increase, what happens? It automatically affects the prices. So the prices increased. So in these war years, the prices have increased. They have doubled between 1913 to 1918, leading to extreme hardship for the common people. At the same time, soldiers. One is war, money in the way of increasing the taxes. Another way, people. And for soldiers, how they have compensated soldiers? So villages. Villages were called upon to supply the soldiers. They have done forced recruitment, in the sense forcefully they started taking village people, young men. They started taking young men forcefully and started sending them into the war. Without proper training, people doesn't know how to use the gun. Without proper training, young people were sent into war and many people have died. Many Indians have died in the war because of this reason. One way, Britishers' exploitation on the Indians in the way of increasing the taxes and forced recruitment. At the same time, nature also has shown its impact on the people. The same year, 1918 and 1919 and 1920-21, there was crop failure due to lack of rainfall, no good harvest. Crop failure, once the crop, it led to shortage of food. At the same time, there was one more impact, that is influenza epidemic. Now we are in the situation of pandemic. Pandemic in the sense spread of disease all over the world is referred to as pandemic. If the spread of disease over a particular community, over a particular region or over a particular area, we call it as epidemic. There was influenza epidemic all over India at this time. So these were all the impact of First World War on the people. One way, during this year of 1914 to 18, so one way, Britishers, by in the way of increasing taxes, in the way of forced recruitment, they were exploiting. Another way, nature also has shown its impact in the way of crop failure, shortage of food and influenza epidemic. So nearly 12 to 13 million people perished in the sense died as a result of famine and epidemic. Because Britishers were, whatever food products, the shortage of food, whatever food is available, it's all been supplied. Whatever money, resources of India, whether it is money, whether it is young people, whether it is food, everything they started supplying to their country, to the soldiers in the war. And Indian peoples were left out with nothing. So no food for the people, famine condition, there was disease, epidemic going on. So millions of people, 12 to 13 million people died during the year 1921. And all the people hoped that once the war is over, now it's their problems are going to stop and they can survive, they will flourish after the war. But that hope also went into vain, because after the war, in order to compensate the losses, the Britishers have become more strict. They started making more stern laws, they started increasing more taxes, collecting more taxes, more hardship for the Indians. At this stage, a new leader appeared and suggested a new mode of struggle. So in our next session, we will discuss who is that new leader and what is his new mode of struggle. Thank you.
Each group developed its own method of struggle against the British rule. The event which proved instrumental in the history of the Indian freedom struggle was the First World War. India had been forced to take part in the First World War, in which Britain had fought against Germany. To continue the war, the British had to increase their defense expenditure and so levied new taxes on Indians to amass money. They introduced income tax and increase the custom duties. The rise in taxes had an adverse effect on the common people, who were forced to live a life of extreme hardship. Another factor which infuriated common people was the forced recruitment of rural people into the army to fight in the First World War. The situation worsened during 1918 when India was hit by crop failure and shortage of food grains. To make matters worse, the crop failure was further followed by famines and outbreak of influenza. This harsh social and political situation set the stage for the beginning of the nationalist struggle in India. The Indian freedom movement gained momentum with the coming of Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, later known as Mahatma Gandhi. He emerged on the national scene in January 1950. Gandhi, later known as Mahatma Gandhi.